First of all, what is it? What is it? That is seminal vesicle here and here, and that is ductus deferens. Ductus deferens, that is ampule, ampulla ductus deferensis, and this ampule joined together with ductus excretorius, and from here start ejaculatory duct and pass through prostate gland. That is prostate gland, and that is urethra. Yeah, that is male urethra. And what is it? Ureter. And what is here? Apex of urinary bladder. Anterior surface, posterior surface, so on. That is penis. Consists of two corpus cavernosum, here and here, right and left corpus cavernosum. This cavernous bodies, not very clear to see, continues into crura penis. Here it is, right and left crura penis, and crura penis attached to inferior ramus inferioris pubis. And this body is corpus spongiosum. Here it is, corpus spongiosum penis. It is unpaired. Posteriorly, it makes wide posterior part, that is bulbus penis, and wide anterior part, that is glans penis. Through corpus spongiosum, we can see male urethra. It passes through corpus spongiosum, that is urethra, and urethra opens with external opening, ostium urethra externum. Glans penis, this posterior border of the glans penis, which is elevated from the level of corpus cavernosum, that is corona glandis, and behind of glans penis, that is neck, column penis. Skin of the glans penis continues into prepuce. Here it is absent, prepuceum, and prepuceum, skin of prepuceum continues into skin of glans penis in the region of frenulum on inferior surface of the glans penis. What else? That is urinary bladder, that is prostate gland, and we can see male urethra. It consists of three parts. First part inside of prostate gland, that is pars prostatica. Next part in place where urethra pass through muscles of urogenital diaphragm. Here it is muscles of urogenital diaphragm. And this short part, it is pars membranata, and it is narrowest part of urethra. And longest part of urethra, that is pars spongiosa, inside of corpus spongiosum penis. Three parts, pars prostatica, pars membranata, and pars spongiosa. Male urethra has three constrictions. First constriction in the beginning, that is ostium urethra internum. Next constriction in the region of pars membranata, it is narrowest part. And last constriction in glans penis, that is ostium urethra externum. And three dilations, wide places of urethra. First in prostate gland, second in bulbus penis, and last, that is in glans penis, that is, it has specific name, fossa navicularis, inside of the glans penis. Urethra has two flexura or curvatura. Curvatura infrapubica, that is pubic symphysis, and curvatura infrapubica below of pubic symphysis. And another curvature, that is curvatura prepubica, here it is in front of pubic symphysis. And this last curvatura is not constant, because if you move penis upward, we can stretch this curvatura. That is why if we need to insert catheter into the urinary bladder, we need to remember only about curvatura infrapubica. Prepubic curvatura, it is not so large problem. We move penis upward, stretch hit is urethra, and only one curvature, only one curvatura we should remember, curvatura infrapubica. And the same you need to know two ligaments. One ligament between pubic symphysis and prostate gland hit is ligamentum puboprostaticum, and another ligament between pubic symphysis and dorsal surface of the penis, that is ligamentum suspensorium penis, suspensory ligament of the penis. This gland is bulbo-urethral gland, that is mucous gland, which opens into urethra, into male urethra, in place in the region of bulbus penis. Here it is, mucous gland opens into urethra. And the function of this gland, that is protection of urethra from urina, that is mucous secret, it's protect mucous membrane of urethra from urine. Give me your manual, please.